Hi everybody. So today we're going to take us through this particular question here, which is based, well, we'll have a read of it and see what it's actually based on. When the moon is exactly half full, Earth, the moon, and the sun form a right angle triangle. So when we look up and we see a half moon, it actually means that the sun, the moon, and the Earth are forming a right angle triangle. At that time, the angle formed by the sun, Earth, and moon. So remember, when we're doing angles, if I did angle ABC, it would be the angle in the middle I would be talking about. Okay, so here they're talking about the angle at the sun, the Earth, the moon. So they are actually talking about this angle here. Is measured to be 89 degrees, and we should know this language here by now, 50 minutes. 58 seconds. The distance from the Earth to the Moon, so from the Earth to the Moon, is 3.4 multiplied by 10 to the power of 8. Now, so I'm going to fill that in here. So 3.4 multiplied by 10 to the power of 8. Now, we know ourselves that this is what we call scientific notation, and we use this to write down either really, really big numbers or really, really small numbers. So, in actual fact, if I was to really write out that number, it would be 3, 4, and what I'd do is I'd move the decimal point out 8 places. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and then I'd have loads of zeros here. Okay, so just give that a quick check. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yeah, so that's actually what that number is, but obviously it's very large, and when we're dealing, we couldn't be putting that into a calculator and trying to multiply it. So when we're dealing with really large numbers or really small numbers, we can use this type of notation, which is called scientific notation. Okay, so let's get back to the question in hand. It says, find the measure of the angle formed when the Earth, the Sun, and the Moon. When the moon is exactly half full. Okay, so we want to find the angle formed by the Earth, Sun, Moon. So Earth, Sun, Moon, which means we're actually looking for the angle at the Sun. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to draw a right angle triangle here just so we can have, I suppose, an easier diagram to look with. And I would always say this when we are dealing with any type of diagram, it's given to us in exam paper. I would say it looks lovely, it's perfect, but you know, we need to make it our own so that we can work away on it. Okay, so I'm going to call this one E for Earth, this one M for Moon, and up here S for Sun. So I'm going to fill in some things that we know. So we know that this here is down here, this angle here is 89 degrees, 50 minutes. And 58 seconds. We know this angle here because we're given it's a right angle triangle, so that is actually 90 degrees. And we're asked to find the angle, let me just pull out again. So we're asked to actually find the angle of the Earth, Sun, Moon. So we're actually asked to find the angle at the Sun, which I'm actually going to put in red there. Now, can we figure out what that angle is? Well, hopefully we can, because we know something about triangles. We know that all angles in any triangle, no matter if they're an equilateral triangle, an isosceles triangle, a scalene triangle, a right angle triangle, they must add up to 180 degrees. So what have we got so far? Here we have 90 degrees, and here we have 89 degrees, 50 and 50, sorry, 50 minutes and 58 seconds. Now that's really, really close to 180, which means this angle here is going to be quite small, okay? So let's add these two up, and then let's subtract them from 180. And remember, we're using our DMS button on our calculators, okay? Okay, so just have a picture of a calculator. So it's that button there that we're going to be using. So we're going to be clicking in 89, then we're going to click that button. 50 minutes, then we're going to click that button again, and in 58 seconds, we're going to click it again, plus 90 degrees. Okay, and then when we get our answer there, we're going to subtract it from from 180. And if you've done it correctly, and I want you to do it on your calculator with me so that you're with me the whole time, you should get 0 degrees, 9 minutes, and 2 seconds. Okay, so I'm going to put that in there now. So 0 degrees, 9 minutes, and 2 seconds. Okay. So a very, very small angle, but nonetheless an angle anyway. All right. So let's first of all give that one a tick. We've got that one done. So the next question says, find the distance from the Earth to the Sun in meters. So Earth to the Sun in meters. So this is what we're looking for. And I'm going to call this X because that's what we're looking for. Is there anything on my diagram I haven't filled in that maybe I was given and I had up here? Ah, let's have a look. 3.4 multiplied by 10 to the power of 8. So let's have that in. 3.4 multiplied by 10 to the power of 8. And remember we said that this is scientific notation. And scientific notation, let's see what it says. So it says, find the distance from the Earth to the Sun in meters. Give your answer in scientific notation. That's what that means. Now, what do these letters here mean? Let's have a little bit of a revision. So the N, they're saying that the N can be anything as long as it's a natural number. So think of what your natural numbers are. They're whole and they're positive. So it can be anything as long as it's a natural number. And then it says this A here has to have a condition. This A has to be less than 10 and bigger than 1. So let's look at the one that we had here. So this is, let's see if it's A multiplied by 10 to the power of N, wasn't that it? So is my N a natural number? It is a natural number, yes. And is my A bigger than 1 and less than 10? It is. It's 3.4. So that's why we wouldn't go 0.34, because that would be less than 1, or we wouldn't leave it as 34, because that would be bigger than 10. So it's important that your number here is bigger than 1 and less than 10. Right, so I've got that filled in and I'm looking for X here. And when I get X, they want me to write it in scientific notation. So I suppose I can't use, it is a right angle triangle, but I can't use Pythagoras because for Pythagoras, I need to know two sides, don't I? And I could know this side and this side, and then I'd be able to find that side. So Pythagoras is not going to work. However, I do have another method with right angle triangles, and that is using my trigonometry. So I'm going to just, if I can, pull this triangle down. Okay, and we're going to use trigonometry to solve this. So with our trigs, remember, we're going to write down our ratios first of all. All right, so I have them down here. So when we write down our ratios, we always then, I suppose, have to figure out, well, which ratio am I going to use? And we do that by focusing on labeling the triangle. So we know that this here is the right angle. So right opposite the right angle is the hypotenuse. So I might do it in blue here. So that's my hypotenuse. Now, you're saying to me, well, this is an angle here and this is an angle here, miss. So which one do I use? It doesn't actually matter here, guys. You can use whichever one you want. I'm going to use this one here. So if that's my angle, then this one here is my opposite. And then this one down here is my adjacent. Okay, right. So now what have I got? I have the adjacent and I'm looking for the hypotenuse. Isn't that it? Sidewise. I have the adjacent and I'm looking for the hypotenuse. So if that's the case, adjacent and hypotenuse, I'm using tan. So it is tan of the angle equals adjacent over hypotenuse. Tan of the angle. What was the angle? Well, remember, I chose this to be my angle. Wasn't that it? I could have chosen this one, but I chose this. Mathematically, it'll work out whichever one you choose. But I chose this one here, which means my angle is 89 degrees, 50 minutes, and 58 seconds. And what I would say is it is probably a better idea to choose the angle you're given, just in case you had made a mistake up here, and then you continued that mistake, if that makes sense. But anyway, so we've got tan of 89 degrees equals adjacent, which is 3.4 multiplied by 10 to the power of 8, all over hypotenuse, which is x. We don't know what that is, so I'm going to call that x. Might make it a nicer x than that one. Now, so I obviously want x on one side, everything else on the other, but this x is stuck in a fraction here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to multiply both sides by x. Okay, and they're going to cancel. And then on this side, then I'm going to just have tan of 89 degrees, 50 minutes, 58 seconds times x equals 3.4 multiplied by 10 to the power of 8. And now I want x on one side, everything else on the other. So I'm going to divide this side by tan to the 89, 50, 58. And then what I do to one side, I must do to the other. So tan of 89 degrees, 50 minutes, 58 seconds. And this and this are going to cancel. And so I'll actually just be left with x on this side. And so I'm going to type everything there into my box. And I should get something 2, 4, 4, 5, 7, 1, 8, 8, 5, 7. So what does this x represent? So let's just think back. So I've just found x, and this was what I had x to be, which is actually the distance from the sun to the earth. So we are talking fairly big numbers here, okay? You know, if we're trying to say that, I think I'd struggle to try and say that number there. But the question, so this is why it's super important to go back to the question now. It says give your answer in the form of scientific notation. So we're going to go back here and we're going to write this in scientific notation. So remember, I'm bringing in my decimal point. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. I'm going to put it here. So the answer that I have is 2.44571 8857 multiplied by 10 to the power of 9. Okay, and hopefully you got on okay with that one there. Take a pause, have a look down at whatever at every aspect there. All right, so we've got a few more parts of this question to do. You can see what I've done here is I've just drawn the diagram just again, filled in all the information that I know. I should probably label it. So what have we got up here? We have the sun, we have the earth, and we have the moon. Okay, so light travels at a speed of 3.1 multiplied by 10 to the power of 8 meters per second. Find the time taken for the light of the sun from the sun to reach the earth. So we're asked here to find time. Now, time is nothing got to do with trigonometry. We know how to find time. We learned it back in first year and we revised it in second year. And it is Dad's silly triangle. Okay, we use this anytime we're looking for distance, speed, or time. So in this case, it says find the time. So we're looking for time. I'm going to give it a bit of a circle there. And it is distance divided by speed. So let's write that down. So time equals distance divided by speed. So find the time taken for the light from the sun to reach the earth. So sun to reach the earth. What's that distance? I think we already know it, don't we? We have it written down already. So it is, instead of writing distance, I'm going to write 2.44571 8857 multiplied by 10 to the power of 9. So that is the distance all over the speed. Well, they actually gave me the speed, didn't they? They were being very nice. The speed is equal to 3.0 multiplied by 10 to the power of 8. So then it's 3.0 multiplied by 10 to the power of 8. And what do we do? We're looking for time. We want time on one side, everything else on the other. We have that. So we are just going to substitute that into my calculator. And when you press that into your calculator, you're going to get, 8.1523. And answer to the correct, the nearest second. So it is 8.15 seconds. But I think actually we could just write 8 seconds there if that's the case. But yeah, there we go. All right, so that is part three. Part four, assuming the Earth's orbits around the sun to be circular. Right, okay. So what are we trying to say here? The Earth orbits around the sun. So an orbit means it goes round in a circle. So assuming the orbit around the sun is circular, find the distance travelled by the Earth in 1 year. Give your answer in scientific notation. Right, so this is quite hard. We need to actually properly visualize this. So let me see if I can, I'm going to put this onto a page. Okay, so what does it mean by orbit? I'm going to see if I can draw a diagram now. They're kind of hard to do, but hopefully you'll see. So this is the distance the Earth stays from the sun as it travels around. So, you know, if I was to do it in red, this is the Earth, and this is the Earth traveling around. Okay, that's what we mean by orbit. So the little planet will go the whole way around. I should probably make this a little bit nicer up here. Okay, it'll go the whole way around. Little planet Earth, it goes the whole way around. And it orbits the sun. Okay, so that means at this point here where we have the Earth, when the Earth is here, it is 2.4457188857 multiplied by 10 to the power of 8 away from the sun. But because it orbits, it never actually changes. So when it's here, okay, so when the little Earth gets the whole way around here, it's still 2.44571885757 multiplied by 10 to the power 1, 10 to the power 9, and the whole way around. So what I would be hoping you would see is that you would see the distance from the sun to the Earth is, hopefully you can see it now if I even get rid of that yellow line. What is that? If that was a circle, what is this? This is a radius. Very good. Hopefully you got that with me. And now we're looking to try and find what's the distance if they went the whole way around that. So if I was, if this was a footpath and I asked you to find the distance around it, you'd be finding the perimeter. Yep. We don't have the word perimeter with a circle, but we do have the word circumference. So I'm asking you to find the circumference of that orbit. Now, circumference has a formula. It's in your log tables, and the circumference is equal to 2 pi r. You probably remember it anyway. So we just need to find the circumference. Did the question say what to take pi as? Let me have a look. No, it doesn't, which means we're going to be using our pi button on our calculator. So if I'm asking to find the circumference, it's 2 multiplied by pi multiplied by the radius, which we have here is 2.44571885757 multiplied by 10 to the power of 9. If you type that into your calculator might actually even give it to you in scientific notation, because sometimes when you input scientific notation, it actually just spits out scientific notation. And if it did correct it two decimal places, your final answer here is 1.54 multiplied by 10 to the power of 10. And that's meters. So, you know, that took a little bit of visualization, but orbit just means it goes round in a circle. And kind of you have that idea that, you know, it orbits, it never gets closer to the sun. Like obviously we never get close to the sun, otherwise we'd burn up. So we must stay the same distance the whole time. And then from the sun out to the Earth is actually a radius. And then finding the whole distance is your circumference. Okay, so we're moving towards the end parts now. So I don't actually have a diagram for this next one because it just says convert 365 1/4 days to seconds. So 365 1/4, we could write that as 365.25. Now, how many seconds is in that? Well, I suppose we have 24 hours in each of those. We have in each of those 24 hours, we have 60 minutes. And in each of those 60 minutes, we have 60 seconds. So that's probably the easiest way to do that. And there are 31,557,600 seconds in every year. So that is interesting. Maybe not, but we'll see. And the last question, it says, find the speed. So we are on a trig, we are in trigonometry at the moment, but we have never learned any trig for speed. We only know for distance, speed and time, dad's silly triangle. So speed is equal to what? Distance divided by time. But remember, your time always has to be as a decimal, or in this case, I think that's why they got us to write it as in seconds, because we are finding meters per second. Okay, so they've gotten us, so the distance then that the Earth travels, well, we found it out in the last bit. So remember, this is the Sun, this is the Earth, this is the Moon, but the Earth orbits the Sun. Okay, so it travels around. So the distance it traveled, we found out that out in the last question, was 1.54 multiplied by 10 to the power of 10, all divided by the time. So the total time is 31,557,600. So if we do that correctly, the final answer here is 488 meters per second. So we're fairly flying it round the Earth, if you think about it like that. So well done on sticking with me. I know that was a really long question, but it just is quite similar to what the questions are like in the exam papers. Little bits of everything. You know, we're never going to get a question on scientific notation, and we're never going to get a question on time and speed, but we could get them thrown into questions with trig. So definitely worth your while going through that question and seeing how you get on.